Space stations are way bigger than you think, and in this video we'll see just how big they are. We'll compare the largest station, the ISS, to others like Skylab and Mir, and see how they stack up to objects right here on Earth. Let's start with the American Skylab, a space station that first launched in May 1973. It measured 100 feet in length and 22 feet in diameter, about as long as a basketball court. In terms of volume, Skylab contained about 12,400 cubic feet of space, equal to about 30 concrete mixer trucks. Since Skylab was built out of the third stage of a Saturn V rocket, it had a cylindrical shape and was very spacious inside. As for its weight, Skylab tipped the scales at approximately 170,000 pounds, or nearly the same as 13 adult African elephants. Now let's move on to the Russian Mir space station, which was launched in February 1986. It measured around 102 feet in length and 90 feet tall. Similar to Skylab, the station offered a pressurized volume of around 12,350 cubic feet. But unlike Skylab, Mir's interior was very cramped and filled with loose hoses, cables, and equipment. In weight, Mir was much heavier than Skylab, coming in at about 300,000 pounds, equivalent to 23 elephants lined up. The ISS, first launched in November 1998, is the largest station ever built. It stretches a massive 357 feet end-to-end, with its solar arrays spanning 240 feet. This is how an adult human compares to the size of the ISS. Now let's bring in an African elephant. It's still a speck compared to the space station. The blue whale is the largest animal alive today, but the ISS is still much larger. The biggest dinosaur ever, Argentinosaurus, is also much smaller than the ISS. Let's talk numbers. If you were to line up all the astronauts who ever stayed on the ISS, it would take around 65 people lying head to toe to match the length of the station from one end to the other. We can also compare the ISS to large objects right here on Earth. Next to a Boeing 747 jet, which is around 231 feet in length, the ISS is over 1.5 times its size. And if you've ever seen one of those massive wind turbines, an average blade is about 150 feet long. The ISS is like stringing together more than two of these blades end to end. If you were to lay the ISS on the ground, it would flow past the end zones of a standard football field. Another example of the scale of the ISS is that if we took the Statue of Liberty and turned it on its side, it would still be smaller than the space station. The ISS is also much larger than both the Skylab and Mir. If we put the Skylab and Mir side by side, they will be nowhere near covering the full length of the ISS. The ISS also offers a pressurized volume of about 32,000 cubic feet, far more than both Skylab and Mir combined. This is more space than a 6-bedroom house, with its interior volume equal to about 80 concrete mixer trucks. The size of the ISS allows it to carry a crew of up to 7 astronauts, which is more than Skylab and Mir, which were each limited to 3 crew members. The ISS is also very heavy, with its mass exceeding 925,000 pounds, akin to about 70 African elephants. Again, the ISS weighs more than Skylab and Mir combined. The SLS Block 1, currently the most powerful rocket in the world, can lift 200,000 pounds to low Earth orbit, and would need 5 missions to lift the mass of the entire ISS to space. SpaceX's Falcon Heavy can lift 141,000 pounds to low Earth orbit in expendable mode, and it would take 7 launches to deliver the ISS to orbit. The solar panels on the ISS are one of the biggest contributors to its overall size. These solar cells can generate up to 240 kilowatts of electricity in direct sunlight, which is used for the station's life support system, general operations, and scientific experiments. One factor in the size of the ISS is its modular design. The station is made up of interconnected modules that serve various purposes. Science labs, living quarters, and even a bay for spacecraft to dock. There are more than 15 pressurized modules, and some of the larger ones include the Russian Zarya and Zvezda modules, the Japanese Kibo module, the American Destiny module, and the European Columbus module. This setup has allowed the ISS to remain versatile and continually expand over the years, making it almost like an evolving city in space. Unfortunately, the ISS won't be around forever, and plans for its retirement are in the works. Like Skylab in 1979 and Mir in 2001, the ISS will eventually crash back down to Earth once it's no longer in use. NASA is currently expecting it to be decommissioned by 2031. The agency's next space station, the Lunar Gateway, will be much smaller. While the ISS orbits Earth, the Lunar Gateway will orbit the Moon and serve as a staging point for missions to the lunar surface and beyond. Although it will play a crucial role in future space exploration, the Gateway's projected volume and length are only a fraction of what the ISS offers today. As the most expensive object ever built at over $150 billion, the size and complexity of the ISS symbolize the ability of our species to put aside our differences and work towards a common goal. Orbiting the Earth at a speed of over 28,000 kilometers an hour, the station provides a window into the wonders of our planet and helps ground our place in the universe. Overall, building something as large as the ISS in space stands out as one of humanity's most impressive achievements. So the next time you gaze up at the night sky and spot that bright moving dot, which is the ISS, or any other space station, remember, they're much, much bigger than you think. With the ISS, you're looking at a football field-sized object over 250 miles away. Not just an engineering marvel, but a testament to what humanity can achieve when we come together. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Feel free to drop a like or leave a comment down below, and subscribe to the channel for more content like this. Hit the bell icon as well for notifications when I upload. I'll see everyone in the next video.